any end of the tunnel. You guys will be allowed masuk Masum. Just tunggu the information from Masum. And insyaAllah nanti kita akan masuk Masum dan kita akan berjumpa. Penat lah, penat memang betul. Saya tak nafikan you guys start from morning kan, daripada pagi tadi and then berterusan sampailah hari Jumaat ni. So saya just nak not quite good because having some bad news. Kenapa? Jangan hiraukan sangat bad news tu. InsyaAllah ada jalan. Ada jalan nanti, solution dia nanti. Doa banyak-banyak. Okay, 10,000 star. Okay, good. Alhamdulillah. Jadi, sedikit kata-kata motivasi untuk anda. If the plan doesn't work, change the plan but never the goal. Okay, so if anything, kalau buat something, ada sesuatu benda yang buat you down atau buat you rasa sedih, just ingat balik apa you punya matlamat untuk belajar di PASU ni, untuk berjaya. And doa banyak-banyak supaya Allah mudahkan jalan. Dan insyaAllah, everything will be fine. Okay, ingat je satu, semuanya akan, walaupun orang kata tu halangan dekat depan, insyaAllah setiap halangan tu ada solution dia. Jadi jangan risau-risau, jangan stres sangat. Just go with the flow, insyaAllah. Alright, so today sebelum saya masuk dalam lecture ketiga, tak susah pun hari ni, maybe kita akan short sikit lah kita punya lecture, okay, tak panjang pun. So saya nak recall sikit daripada lecture 2 yang kita buat, is the kinematic equation that we can use the kinematic equation for linear motion. Tapi kita boleh guna dalam rotational motion, but we have to change lah, they change the linear parameter or linear quantities menggunakan angular quantities. So for example, I take the fourth one, yang ni. Kita tahu that V final square is equal to V initial square pluskan dengan 2S fraction delta S for linear motion. But kita boleh menggunakan this linear motion, but we have to change it into kita punya angular quantity. So for example, V final dekat sini, dia correspond to our angular velocity finals. And initial also angular velocity initial. And A is correspond to our angular acceleration. And also delta S correspond to our angular displacement. Jadi if you memorize all of this punya kinematic equation, when you cari ataupun buat soalan related to the kinematic equation rotational motion, insyaAllah you boleh buat macam soalan tutorial yang keempat dan kelima. Okay, next. Okay, ini adalah beberapa juga yang saya cuba summarizekan daripada apa yang kita belajar sebelum ni di lecture 2 and lecture 1, di mana we have velocity and acceleration. Okay, selain daripada angular velocity, the label is omega and the unit is radian per second. And acceleration also, we have angular acceleration, the label is alpha like that, and the unit is radian per second square. Okay, then we also have the tangential and centripetal part. So for velocity, they have a tangential part, okay, but they don't have the centripetal part. So we know that the tangential velocity is r omega, okay, and then the tangential acceleration is r times with angular acceleration, but the centripetal acceleration, the one that we will introduce today, okay, the new one, AC. But centripetal velocity, it is not applicable for us. So sebab the velocity for centripetal, the velocity is only works on the circular motion. The it is always tangential to the circle, to the path of the motion. Okay, so this one that we will learn today. Okay, nanti kita akan derive how kita akan derive lah. How to derive the centripetal acceleration itself, and then kita akan guna the equation untuk solvekan centripetal acceleration problem. Okay, related macam soalan tu suruh mencari centripetal acceleration. Kita belajar centripetal acceleration because nanti untuk next lecture ataupun lecture esok kita akan menggunakan centripetal acceleration untuk mencari centripetal force. Okay, but for today I will ajar centripetal acceleration. Okay, maybe saya tak update dekat yang tak boleh scan QR code. Saya tak update dekat dekat the Teams. I will post it now. Sekejap eh. FA physical 2. Physical 2. Sekejap, saya upload yang baru. Okay, wait. Okay. Okay, nanti cuba check balik dekat post tu. Saya baru post yang baru. Nanti you try untuk scan balik. Okay, next. Today is our lecture is about centripetal acceleration. Tak susah. Derivation dia, a bit of derivation. And then kita akan guna that formula untuk cari centripetal acceleration. Okay, centripetal acceleration bermaksud, I define centripetal acceleration as acceleration directed toward the center. Because centripetal itself means center seeking. So the acceleration will always point to the center. Sebelum ni tangential acceleration, that acceleration correspond to the acceleration yang tangentially to the circle. Okay, soalan saya. Can an object accelerate if it's moving with constant angular velocity? I will open a poll. Okay, sekejap. Open the poll. Then you guys may answer. Can an object accelerate if it's moving with constant velocity? Yes or no? Okay, you guys can respond. Ramai yang kata no, ada yang kata yes, seorang kata unsure. I'll open for 40 more seconds. Masih lagi yang berfikir ke kan? If before this dekat linear motion, tu memang belajar bila velocity tu sama, acceleration akan jadi kosong sebab velocity is constant kan? Tapi how about our circular motion? Azhan, Azim, Alim, semua lelaki. Alright, nanti I'll close the submission. Okay. Saya akan panggil seorang untuk menerangkan kenapa dia pilih yes. 41 orang kata yes, antaranya ni lah nama-nama yang tertera ni. Saya akan panggil Akmal Faris dari FM2. Okay, kenapa you kata yes? Why the acceleration still exists if the velocity is the same? Akmal Faris, FM2.
Because the direction changes.
The direction changes. Okay, that's it.
Yes.
Right. Okay. Seorang lagi, maybe Nadirah dari APF. Nadirah dari APF.
Actually, I'm not sure about that. So I guess.
You just guessing. Okay, it's okay. Okay, tak apa. Saya nak lagi seorang. Darwish dari FK1. Darwish dari FK1. You say yes.
Saya buat. I only do assumptions.
Or you just assume that it has acceleration even the magnitude is same. Alright, no problem. So Akmal, only Akmal sajalah yang ada reason. Okay, I want to say no. I will ask Nabil Nuruddin FL2. Kenapa you kata no?
Because when we constant, no acceleration.
Okay, so and then the magnitude is the same, then there's no acceleration, is it? Alright, okay. And then the other one, tak apalah, memang jawapan dia yang no ni memang pilih sebab there is no velocity lah, the changes in velocity. Okay, jawapan dia sebenarnya adalah yes. Dia ada acceleration because acceleration ni adakah ianya vector ataupun scalar?
Vector.
Okay, what vector means? Apa vector?
Magnitude and direction.
Yes. Yeah, it has magnitude and it has direction. For circular motion, even the magnitude of the velocity is the same, but the direction changes because of the apa nama? Bila saya lukis satu bulatan kat sini kan? Okay, the point here, the velocity is here, pointing here. If the point here, the velocity is pointing to the left, and it will always change the direction, in direction. So therefore, vector acceleration mesti wujud lah, and we call it centripetal acceleration. And centripetal yang macam saya cakap tadi, it is always pointing to the center. So this is the centripetal acceleration. Always point to the center. Okay, so this what we call it as AC. Okay, now saya tekankan lagi sekali, even the magnitude the same, but the direction is always changing in circular motion. In linear memang lain lah, dia always satu hala je kan, but in circular motion it always changes. So that's why lah dia adanya acceleration yang wujud. We call it centripetal acceleration. Alright, next. Okay, this is how we want to derive centripetal acceleration. Okay, saya bagi satu analogi yang mudah. Akmal maybe boleh mute maybe sebab ada macam noise sikit. Okay, consider an object initially at point P. Okay, I have an object at point P with the velocity of, I call it V initial. Okay, the one that always tangential to the circle, we call it tangential velocity ataupun VT. So VI ni correspond to VT lah. And then after a time P, dia ada dekat Q, dia move kat Q with, I call it as V final. Okay, so itu satu. And then kita akan assume V1 and VF ni will always differ in direction. Sebab memang nampak kalau saya lukis the arrow here, yang ini memang menuju ke sini. And then the V final here is always menuju ke sini. So we can see even the vector or the magnitude is the same, tapi dia punya direction berubah. Okay, and V final tolak V initial takkan dapat kosong. Okay, even the magnitude are same. Saya tekan guys sekali sebab adanya direction. Okay, next, let's visualize. Okay, saya akan zoom part ni. Okay, when kita zoom, kita akan nampak this V initial dekat P ni, it always tangentially to the circle, and also V final Q tangentially to the circle at this point. Okay, and then saya akan bawa this this arrow untuk saya formkan segitiga. Dia akan jadi macam ni. So V initial yang anak panah ni kan, saya bawa pergi ke sini. Okay, and then yang V final yang ni saya bawa juga pergi ke sini. And then I will form satu triangle, and I call this as a first triangle. So triangle satu. Okay, so since the velocity, the magnitude of the velocity sama, jadi dia punya kaki tu samalah, panjang VF ni dengan panjang VI ni jadi sama. Jadi bila kita resultant kan dia, dia akan dapat satu the delta V. We call it as a V yang always points directly towards the center of the curvature. Okay, this is triangle yang pertama. Okay, triangle yang kedua datangnya daripada yang warna purple tu. Okay, yang this one. Okay, bila saya keluarkan this triangle, dia jadi macam ni. Jadi dia ada radius with the same leg, sebab radius kan sama kan. And then dia ada theta. And since the delta T is very small, jadi the base yang the base of this triangle actually sama dengan the arc length here. Okay, the arc length of delta S here. That's why I just assume if the delta T is very small, jadi the base akan correspond to S delta S. Okay, this I call it as triangle 2. Okay, and both triangle ianya adalah isosceles, di mana the leg, apa, the panjang kaki tu adalah sama. So saya akan pindahkan both of this segitiga to the next slide. Okay, this is the first triangle tadi, and then this is the second one. Okay, macam saya cakap tadi, the leg of the first triangle, V initial, it correspond to V initial and also V final. And we also know that V initial and V final is equal to V tangential. Sebab bila saya tengok balik dekat this, okay, saya nampak the one that always tangentially to the circle, it always, kita panggil dia V tangential kan, VT. Jadi VI and VT ni is actually a tangential velocity. Jadi saya boleh tulislah part ni, V initial, V final is equal to V tangential. And also the base of the segitiga delta V is equal to the changes in the final velocity minus V initial. Even the magnitude are the same, but it will not be zero because of the direction. Okay, and then for the second one, we have delta S as base, and then the kaki is the radius, and both have the same leg. Jadi we use the properties of two similar triangles menggunakan mathematics punya identities, where the base of the triangle 1, the base of the triangle 1 is delta V, right? Jadi we divide with the leg. Okay, the leg dia sama ada V initial or V final. And this V initial and V final is equal to the tangential velocity. That's why the base of the triangle first bahagikan dengan kaki dia V tangential. Okay, this is for the first triangle. And the second one, the delta S, the base of the second triangle divided by the kaki dia. Kaki of the second triangle is radius. Jadi we have this equation. And then I bring the Vt to the right hand side, then we can rearrange the formula to become the delta V is equal to Vt yang saya dah bawa ke sebelah kanan ni, and it is equal to delta S over R. Okay, jadi bila dah dapat these equations, kita divide the equation by delta T both sides, and the delta V kita dividekan delta T. And delta S, Vt over R is a constant, jadi I factorize it outside, Vt over R. And it left delta S only, and delta S I just divide by delta T. Okay, and from this equation, kita boleh nampak, the changes in velocity with time, with respect to time. And this is always something that we know, bila velocity berubah, jadi bila velocity berubah dari segi masa, jadi ianya adalah sejenis acceleration. And we know that this acceleration is centripetal acceleration. Okay, so this is centripetal acceleration. And then Vt over R is the constant. And the changes in displacement, S over T, is actually is a velocity, tangential velocity. Because S is kita punya linear quantities, jadi ianya menjadi tangential velocity. And kita dah form satu equation di mana acceleration centripetal is equal to Vt over R. Okay, this one datang daripada sini And then delta S over delta T is also V tangential. Then kita boleh deducekan that the AC is equal to V tangential to the power of 2 divided by R. And also daripada knowledge yang sebelum ni, we know that the tangential velocity is equal to R omega. We also can rearrange this formula. Kita formkan dalam bentuk AC is equal to, in terms of omega, which is Vt is equal to R omega. So Vt, we put R omega to the power of 2 divided by R. Then we expand this, kita akan dapat R square omega square divided by R. Then we just can cancel out the value of R here. And AC can be presented in two ways lah. The first one is in the form of tangential velocity, where AC is equal to Vt over R to power of 2, and the other one is AC is equal to R omega to the power of 2. This one is in term of angular velocity. Alright, before I proceed, any question?
How?
Syamil Hafiz tak mute mic. So saya dengar macam ada noise. Okay, thank you Syamil. Okay, ada question before I proceed to the next slide? Tak ada. Okay, good. Tak apa, kita tengok soalan supaya awak lebih faham. Okay. Okay, before that, sebelum soalan, kita dah tahu that is acceleration ada dua. Satu is tangentially, which is the tangential to the circle, and the another one is the centripetal, the one that we just derive. Okay, so bila kita nak the total of acceleration, kita menggunakan the resultant punya equation lah, where AC to power of 2 plus AT power of 2, and then you solve for the AC, kita tahu R omega square, and this one lah, right? But AT is always zero untuk case uniform circular motion. Okay, so macam mana nak tahu dia uniform circular motion? The question akan bagi tahulah the case that the AT is circular, is uniform or not. Okay, jadi bila the tangential velocity is zero, it only left centripetal acceleration. And this AT and AC, the unit must be in meter per second square. Okay, it is linear. Okay, kita tengok soalan, contoh-contoh soalan yang will ask you how to find the centripetal acceleration. Okay, example one. Find the magnitude of the centripetal acceleration of a car following a curve of radius 500 meter at a speed of 25 meter per second. Okay, untuk calculate centripetal acceleration, apa yang kita perlu ada? What parameter that we should have? First sekali is radius. Lagi satu?
Omega.
Another one. Selain omega, kita kena ada. Kita boleh juga ada. Yes, tangential velocity. Okay, in this question, apa yang dia bagi? R dia bagi.
R.
And R omega ke tangential velocity?
VT.
VT. Sebab omega. Sebab omega, unit dia is radian per second. This one is meter per second. So this one should be VT. Dia bukannya angular velocity. So in order untuk differ that the quantity is angular or not angular, so you look at the unit. So bila daripada unit tu, you tahu, okay, this is the tangential velocity, not angular velocity. The question give you radian per second, revolution per minute. That one memang indicates that that quantity is angular. Okay, so we have AC, the formula is VT, V tangential to the power of 2 divided by R. Jadi V tangential given in the equation is 25 meter per second. Okay, we divided by the radius is 500 meter. Jadi what is our centripetal acceleration? Can someone help me to calculate this?
1.25.
Yeah, 1.25. Unit is?
MS negative 2.
Yes, MS negative 2. So, centripetal acceleration, the unit mesti menggunakan SI. Angular acceleration only yang guna radian per second to power 2. Tangential acceleration also, dia akan guna meter per second square. Okay, next. Kita tengok. Sangat senang, straightforward. Okay, tengok yang example tu. A rock tied to a string is moving at a constant speed of 8 meter per second. So, what is this? This is?
Tangential
velocity. Tangential velocity in a circle of radius. So, this would be radius lah. So, calculate the approximate magnitude of the centripetal acceleration of the rock. So, kita dah tahulah. We have AC is equal to tangential velocity to the power of 2. We divided by 7 radius. Then we sum in the value given. Divided by 7. So jawapan dia adalah 64 divided by 7.
9.14.
Unit is meter per second. Okay, senang kan? Very straightforward. Dah ada information, then you can calculate the centripetal acceleration. Okay, I will increase the level of difficulties for this question, the first question that you guys can try. Okay, a ball is attached to a string that is 1.5 meter long, and it is spun so that it completes 2 full rotation every second. What is the AC felt by the ball? Okay, I'll open the answer box. Then you may calculate and then try to start calculating and then boleh jawab. So dekat soalan ni memang we know that the direct punya information given is the radius. The one that we don't have now is the angular velocity. What is the angular velocity? Memang ada dalam soalan. So you try to decipher the question and try to calculate the value of centripetal acceleration. Okay, I will wait. Sekarang ni 6 orang sahaja yang menjawab. Okay, good. Okay, I will open another 10 seconds. All right, I'll close the submission. Okay. So, 24 people menjawab A, semua betul. Dan saya tengok ada jawab B, Hazim dan Ain, and also Faisal menjawab D. Tak apa, kita tengok kenapa, where did you go wrong? Okay, jawapan dia A. Okay, tengok macam mana nak solve this question. Okay, sekejap. I need to open my blackboard. Okay, so given in the question that the radius is equal to 1.5 meters. Okay, it start raining outside. Hopefully you didn't hear any noise. Okay, and then given also that the velocity, the angular velocity yang memang ternyorok sikit dalam this question, dia bagi tahu the angular velocity is, dia bagi tahu is it completes to full rotation. Dia dah tahu dah ni, to full rotation every second. So ini bermaksud sebenarnya to full rotation, which is to revolution lah, sebab rotation ni sama je dengan revolution. Full rotation, full revolution. So I put it as to revolution per second. Macam tu. Then we know that this is our angular velocity. Jadi this one is not in radian per second. We have to convert it into radian per second to revolution per 1 second. Okay, how to convert revolution to radian?
Multiply 2 pi.
Yeah, we multiply by 2 pi and second is already in second. We don't have to touch that. Jadi jawapan untuk omega in radian per second is 4 pi radian per second. Okay, or else if you want to value the value of pi also, tak ada masalah. It will give you the same answer also. So 4 pi darabkan, so 4 pi is equal to 12.57 radian per second. Then you look at the answer, the apa nama, pilihan jawapan. It's in point, ya? Dia bukannya in pi punya jawapan akhir. Jadi you use this one lah, lagi senang, tak perlu nak kira nanti kemudian. Okay, we have omega, we have radius. Jadi kita punya centripetal acceleration, we can use the second one, the centripetal acceleration that related to the omega. AC is equal to R omega to the power of 2. Jadi our radius is what, 1.5, and omega is 12.57 to the power of 2. So our centripetal acceleration is
237.
Tak dengar.
236.87.
The unit is meter per second square. Okay, boleh yang salah tadi Faisal, you tengok balik kenapa you silap, but this is the correct workings lah. Alright, next. Kita tambah lagi kesusahan dia. Okay, a ferry boat makes a 180 degree turn in 12 minutes. The radius of the turn is 0.5 miles. What is its centripetal acceleration in meter per second square during the turn? And dia bagi kat sini the relationship antara antara 1 miles dengan meter is 1609 meter. Okay, you may start to calculate. Alright, so tengok jawapan memang pelbagai. No worries, kita boleh belajar dari kesilapan. 54. Okay, Syahmi daripada FM1, 31,000, macam the value pun nampak macam tak betul kan. So tak apa, kita boleh tengok nanti the solution. Okay, Hafiz punya saya rasa betul, 0.0153. Alright, Wan Nur Sharina, Iqmal, okay good. Faris, Malik, Kemal Faris, okay good. Tak, fan saya silap. Siapa fan saya ni? Fans tu. Okay, bagai korang ni. Okay, tak apa, kita tengok dia punya solution. Okay, dekat sini memang betul-betul juga dia memang ada information yang quite tersirat sikit. But we know yang, apa nama, alamak salah tu. Sekejap saya punya pen hilang. Okay, siap. Okay, so kita tahu that time, yang ini, we know lah, this one is time. Okay, this one is radius. But this one we macam tak tahu. What is this end? Okay, jadi we know the radius is 0.5 miles. Jadi kita just terus convert it into meter. So 0.5 darabkan dengan 1609. Jadi kita dapat untuk radius adalah 804.5 meter. Okay, then this fine lah. But untuk calculate the centripetal acceleration, we need to have angular velocity or the tangential velocity. Jadi kat sini kita tahu dia ada bagi tahu that the boat makes a 180 degree. So 180 degree. 180 degree ni actually apa? And also time. Okay, apa maksud 180 degree?
Pi.
Ya, pi itu apa? Pi. Dia mewakili apa?
Angular displacement.
Yes, correct. It is angular displacement. Jadi we know that the omega is equal to the angular displacement divided by time. So daripada sini lah kita boleh dapat angular displacement where the angular, kita boleh dapat angular velocity. Angular displacement is 180 degree. Jadi this one is in degree. We have to convert it into radian. So 180 degree bersamaan pi rad. Okay, and then the time is 12 minutes. So we have to convert it into second. Kita darabkan dengan 60. Maybe ada yang tak tukar minit kepada 60. So ada salah jugalah dekat situ. Jadi our omega now is equal to pi over 720 radian per second. Okay, ni bukan final answer. We need to find further the centripetal acceleration where kita dah ada angular velocity, we have the radius, dan kita gunalah this one, r omega to the power of 2. Jadi the radius is 804.5. Okay, and then we multiply with our angular velocity pi over 720. And then the final answer of the centripetal acceleration is berapa?
0.0153.
Yep, 0.015. Unit is meter per second square. Okay. Okay, so yang ni ada kuasa 2, omega kuasa 2. Okay, senang, but the only problem is when you want to find and when you want to look at what is the angular velocity in the equation. So you have to decipher that. Okay, the last one. A helicopter circles continuously at a constant speed around a horizontal path of diameter. Okay, given the diameter is 800 meter and the time is 5 minutes to complete each orbit. Each orbit. Ini dia punya keyword. Each orbit of the path. So what are the speed? Soalan minta speed. Okay, bukannya angular velocity. Dia minta speed in V. And also centripetal acceleration A of the helicopter. I'll open the response. And you may start calculating. I'll wait for your answer. Okay, cuba fikir elok-elok apa angular velocity daripada this question. I will add another 1 minute. Tak ada siapa yang jawab ke tak boleh jawab? Masih memikirkan. Each orbit tu maksud dia satu revolution lah tu. One 360 degree or 2 pi. So 2 pi in 5 minutes. Then you can find the angular velocity. And then you can calculate for the tangential velocity. And then you can calculate, further calculate for centripetal acceleration. Oh, no one answer. So you guys tak boleh answer. Okay, dah nampak dah. Seorang tu. One handsome. Okay. Ah, okay. Fan saya silap. Sebab dia stop at the angular velocity, not the tangential velocity. So we want the angular velocity. Okay, we have 10 seconds more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright. So kalau tengok dekat sini, sekejap. Farid 002. Okay, this one memang Farid memang dia stop at the angular velocity, not the tangential velocity. So you have to times the radius lah untuk dapatkan tangential velocity. Okay, and then Haris Ikwan, ramai yang stop at the angular velocity. Okay, the question memang suruh cari tangential velocity. Tangential velocity just R omega je, darabkan dengan radius. Okay, sama juga Akmal Faris, correct. Okay, Aiman FL3, betul. Asfalina also 0.021 ni is not meter per second eh, Asfalina. It is actually a radian per second. Awak stop dekat omega, bukannya tangential velocity. Sama juga saya punya fan pun silap dekat 0.22 ni. Mana dia dapat pun, I'm not sure. 0.0315, maybe ada kesilapan mengira. Daniel, okay, nanti kita tengok dekat mana you silap. Alright, so I'll close this. Okay, helicopter circle, memang dalam question dia memang sangat, dia bagi benda yang tersirat kan. Jadi the diameter given is 800. Okay, this one diameter bukannya radius. Dah silap kat sini. Jadi radius adalah 400 meter. Okay, we have to divide by 2 lah. And then time dia bagi is 5 minutes. Yang ni kalau tak convert kepada second pun dah silap. So we have to times 60. So it is equal to 300 second. Okay, and then dia bagi complete each orbit. Satu orbit, satu orbit maksud dia satu revolution. Jadi kita punya theta is 1 revolution, right? And it is equal to 2 pi. Okay, kita tukar terus kepada benda yang, kepada unit yang diperlukan. Okay, radian. And then also time is, time dah bagilah 5 minit tadi. Okay, and then soalan, ask for the centripetal, no, ask for the tangential speed. Jadi we know that Vt, tangential speed, the equation is R times with the omega. Jadi omega is equal to, dapat daripada this displacement, angular displacement and also the time. So omega is 2 pi rad divided by the time, 300 second. So the omega is equal to, anyone?
Zero point zero two one.
Okay, this unit is radian per second, not the tangential speed. Tangential speed unit is meter per second. In order untuk cari tangential speed, we have to multiply with the radius. So the radius is 400. Darabkan 0.021. So our tangential speed is 8.38 right, meter per second. Okay, ini adalah tangential speed. Okay, for centripetal acceleration, kita dah ada omega, kita dah ada centripetal, kita dah ada tangential speed. Jadi we can use either one lah. So either you want to use AC is equal to R omega to the power of 2, or you want to use AC is equal to V tangential power of 2 divided by radius. So I will choose this. Okay, benda yang sama je. And radius is 400. And our omega just now we calculate is 0.021 to the power of 2. So our centripetal acceleration is mengeluh dia. 0.175 meter per second. Okay. Kalau guna ni pun boleh sebab VT tadi we calculate is 8.38 meter per second to the power of 2 divided by the radius is 400. And then you akan dapat jawapan yang sama juga. Okay, bendanya simple, cuma you nak dapatkan the information dalam pada dalam soalan tu. Okay, I think that's all for centripetal acceleration. Sebab nanti untuk next, untuk tomorrow punya lecture, where we will introduce, I will introduce you of centripetal force. Okay, kita akan start masuk dynamics. Okay, force, bermain dengan force. Centripetal force, kita akan guna the Newton second law where F is equal to ma. Jadi centripetal force is equal to m v times with the centripetal acceleration. So yang ini yang kita akan guna besok lah banyak. But I will introduce, I will derive this equation for you guys untuk besok. So before I end my lecture, okay, ini adalah QR code untuk hari ini. Okay, before I end my lecture, dalam masa tu, any question from the floor? Tak ada satu. Tak ada dua. Okay, tak ada tiga. If ada, kalau malu nak tanya, you just approach me dekat my Teams. Ni, kalau ada WhatsApp, we boleh juga boleh WhatsApp me. So, ada masalah, jangan senyap. Okay, jangan simpan, jangan pendam. Cuba luahkan perasaan anda. Okay, so kita jumpa insyaAllah besok untuk centripetal force and make sure awak faham betul-betul angular acceleration, angular velocity, centripetal acceleration, tangential acceleration, semua benda-benda ni bila awak dah faham, awak tahu, awak boleh deferkan dalam soalan, oh this is centripetal acceleration, this is angular velocity, then you will be okay lah untuk kita punya dynamics nanti. Sebab dynamics, we play around with the force and also the resultant force and so on lah. So jangan risau, and if tak nampak lagi, pergi balik I punya lecture, then baca and then buat a lot of question. Okay, so saya rasa itu sahaja hari ini. Boleh berehat. Kita jumpa esok insyaAllah. Assalamualaikum semua. Bye.
Terima kasih.